Information about the attack on the kosher supermarket in New Jersey. Officials now saying flat out, this was a hate crime, an act of terrorism.
Plus, we'll talk about hate crimes in America with Professor Frederick Lawrence. He's a distinguished lecturer at Georgetown Law and author of Punishing Hate, Bias Crimes Under American Law. That's next.
And we have Mr. Frederick Lawrence with us now. He is a distinguished lecturer at Georgetown Law, former president of Brandeis University, and author of Punishing Hate, Bias Crimes Under American Law. Good morning to you, sir. Thank you for being with us.
Hi, Christy. Good to be with you.
Thank you. When you first heard about this and started reading about this incident there in Jersey City, what stood out to you as evidence of a hate crime?
Well, the fact that they traveled quite a distance to commit this crime, that they picked this particular location, which is known to be a congregating place for the Jersey City Jewish community, the fact that it's a kosher market next to a synagogue, next to a school, all of these are powerful pieces of evidence of motivation. People worry about how do you prove racial motivation, and sometimes it's hard. I regret to say sometimes it's actually not hard at all, and this case looks like a very powerful case for a religiously motivated hate crime.
I know that, you know, social media sites are pretty fertile ground for some of these hate groups to grow and to proceed here. We know that there are threads on Facebook, on YouTube, on Reddit. Is there any legal navigation to break down these groups without infringing on, you know, some might say some of it is First Amendment right? Where is the breakdown there?
Well, look, the answer is people can express hateful views, but they can't act on those hateful views. So how do you address it when it's happening? The answer is that words have consequences, not just hateful words, but also helpful words. And those have to come from all sources. I think if you listen to what, for example, the Jersey City mayor has said about this crime, that's the kind of talk that is extremely helpful, that he says it's important that we label this as a hate crime. And he's right. And I think making that message loud and clear that you influence people who would otherwise potentially be drawn to this kind of behavior.
That could be dangerous. Is there
Absolutely.
A rise in hate crimes as we see it, or are we just getting better at identifying?
That's a great question, and I think the answer is that we've gotten better at identifying over the past decade. So what appears to be happening over the past couple of years is in fact a rise in hate-motivated behavior, which is extremely disturbing. I have to tell you, when I first wrote Punishing Hate, I dearly hoped that by this point these issues would be well behind us and we'd be on to other things that we were talking about as a society. I would never have dreamed that we would still be dealing with this. But if we are, then it is terribly important that we call these crimes what they are. You know, these crimes don't just have an impact on the individual victims. You've got Jewish Americans all over the country who feel victimized by this. It's not just a sense of sort of sympathy that they feel, you know, bad for the people for whom this happened. They actually feel victimized themselves. This is the classic pattern of a hate crime, you know, where there's an AME Baptist church that is vandalized someplace. It's not just the people at that church. It's African Americans all over the country who feel victimized.
Real quickly, Mayor Bill de Blasio says that a new NYPD unit is going to investigate extremist online hate crimes. How impactful do you think that could be? Good start?
Could be. If you assign people to actually be focused on that, then they will pay more attention. And I also think it has a salutary effect for people who might otherwise be drawn to this to know that the police are paying attention. Again, you don't want to restrict speech. You don't want to restrict expression. But people have to know that when they operationalize those beliefs in a criminal way, that those will not only be punished, but punished at a higher level because they exact a deeper harm on the individuals, on the target community, and really on the entire society.
Frederick Lawrence, very thoughtful mindset there. Thank you so much for the conversation. Good to have you.
Thank you. Good being with you.